أطعمهم من جوع. Okay? من جوع. Say, أطعمهم. Now you put the lips together, and when you smell mama's cookies, you say, Everybody go, Hey, ladies, don't talk. That's rude, and it's not accepted. Okay? You have, if you have a question, Wallahi, just ask the question. It's no problem. Just second line. What's the question?
What is that? Before Iqam and...
Oh, I was just scribbling, scrabbling.
No, the second line of
this one? Wasemmi. Wasemmi. Idghaman saghiran ya fata. Wasemmi. You should have this poem now. He should give you a copy of the poem. No one should be just writing the poem down. You know what? Actually, the first rule for studying a text is the first lesson is tahqiqul nas. The first lesson is always to take the whole text and check to make sure that the writing of the text is right, is done. Okay? That all the whole text is done. Once it's done, now you can start studying it. Because it doesn't help to memorize it and then lose the memorization because you made a mistake like that. So that's supposed to happen. If you want to blame anybody, you can blame me. It's my fault. Because I didn't think I gave it to him or anything like that. But you should be able to have it now. I had the tahqiq. Plus, I wanted to get a tahqiq from a high isnad. Everything is isnad. You know, we say we ahl al-hadith. Some people talk that talk, but they front. We don't want to be perpetrators of frauds. We don't be counterfeit. Everything with us is having a chain back to the author in this regard. The text has been in some controversy. So the text that we have is from Ayman Sheikh Dr. Ayman Suwaid, Rushdie Suwaid. And it's a short isnad that we have. Okay? And it's been checked, tahqiqan. And we had it for a couple weeks now, right? But how come I didn't give it? Did I give it to you? How come I didn't give it to you last week? That's not acceptable. I would blame McKean and Hakeem. McKean and Hakeem. Whoa. There you go. That rhymes. Or you say, Hakeem Hakeem. And we're idgham. Hakeem Hakeem. Anyway, here. Ata'amahum min. That's all we need to know. Ata'amahum min. Here, the point is to put your lips together. It's cool. It's cool. It's to put your lips together like this. How many memes are here, people? No, two memes. How many memes are here? Three memes. Name them. Point them out. What's this one? One. How many are here?
Two.
What's the third one then?
That's the first and second.
Ah, so it's the second and third right here. Why do they do it like this? Because the Arabs love what?
Abbreviation.
The Arabs love abbreviation. So instead of putting two memes, they put a shadda over it, which means two memes. So there's three memes. So how much time do you have? What's a haraka? Say it loud, man. Say it like you know it. What is it?
The time you take to open a finger or close a finger.
The time it takes for you to open your finger or close it. Not saying give the finger. We're saying open the finger or close the finger, right? Like that. So how long should that be?
Three
harakat. So you say, ata'amahum min. You see that? That's how long it should be. But to do it, some people do it wrong. They say, ata'amahum min. Were you rushing? That's where you going? Take your time. Give it its three hours. Some people go along and say, that's wrong. Give it its right and step off it. Step on it, stop, step away. Okay? That's how you do with that. Everybody, do we need another example? وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مَنَهُمْ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. Right? وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. Here, you join these together. Here, you join these. This right here is said together. وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. Say it with me. أَطَعَمَهُمْ مِنْ. Put your lips together. No, don't go. Here, you put your lips together. وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ.
وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ.
You hear that? You should feel the difference. Everybody got that rule? It's pretty easy. Can we go on? All right, erase the board. Oh, I'm sorry. We haven't. Yeah, erase all of this. Then it goes on, idghaman saghiran ya fata. Now here, usually for a beginner, we would just say, it's the small idgham, right? The minor idgham. But because y'all are tusk, tusk means the ultimate talib al-ilm, the ultimate students of knowledge, we're going to explain idghaman saghiran. Okay? Idghaman saghiran is, there's two types of idgham. Ind al-qurra, according to the people who recite during different qira'at. In the qira'ah of Hafs and Asim, they have the idghaman saghir, where you put one letter that comes after the other one. When you say, idrib bi'asak, say that, idrib bi'asak. You see that? Idrib bi'asak. You see this right here? Idrib bi'asak, right? The ba-ba, right there. You got that? Then you have another one. وَقَدْ دَخَلُوا قَدْ دَخَلُوا. You see that? قَدْ دَخَلُوا. This is idgham, because the dal is into the other dal. The ba is into the other ba. Just like we just said, أَطَعَمَهُمْ مِنْ. Right? اِضْرِبْ بِهِ قَدْ دَخَلُوا. You following me? That's the small idgham. When you get into the qira'ah of Susi and Ibn Amr, you know, the Susi of Ibn Amr, Abu Amr, because you have Ibn Amr and you have Abu Amr. You have Susi on Abu Amr, when his qira'ah, he makes the big idgham. And if you know the Qur'an in Suratul Kaf, no, it's not Kaf, Suratul, I know why I thought Kaf, because it's Suratul Maryam. He says, Kaf, haya, ayn, sad, dhikru rahmat rabbika abadahu zakariya. إذ نادى ربه نداء خفيا قال ربي اشتعل رأسي شيبة. اشتعل رأسي شيبة. So that's the line. He says اشتعل. What did he say? اشتعل واشتعل 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 رأسي شيبة. واشتعل لا رأسي شيبة. Meaning his hair became white, right? Ishta'ala ra'si shayba. Now, in the idgham of Susi, he doesn't pronounce the hamza. Okay? Pay attention, guys. I don't want you looking up. You know, Ibrahim al-Nakhai, famous scholar, rahimahullah, Sheikh Ibrahim al-Nakhai, very tough. If he saw people doing anything, he would grab his shoes and run in his house. They say he didn't like to teach. He'd get away from me. You know what I said? So, you know, some, I don't like that, because you have to pay attention, because you miss the point, inshallah ta'ala. Look. Washta'ala ra'su. Ra'su shayba. Okay? This is the line. Now, what happens when Susi recites it, he doesn't recite the hamza. And he makes idgham. How can we make idgham? Because the small idgham is with like letters. Ba ba, dal dal, mim mim, ata'amahum min. Right? Amanahum min. Right? Here, this idgham is kabir. So it's a seen and sheen because they're similar. So he says, washta'ala ra shayba. You hear that? Washta'ala ra shayba. That's the idgham kabir. So when he says, وَسَمِّ إِدْغَامًا صَغِيرًا يَا فَتَى, يَا فَتَى, oh young person, okay? Take it easy, shorty, you know? You got the small idgham. And the small idgham is with like letters, right? Ba on ba, del on del. Do I have to stop, Imam? Is that? Okay, I'm finished this line here, okay? Jazakallah khair. And the big idgham is with similar letters, okay? Similar, they're not even like letters. And they're mutaharrik. Whereas this one is not mutaharrik and the second one is mutaharrik. Do you understand that right there? So this is what the line means. And it says, وَسَمِّ إِدْغَامًا صَغِيرٍ. It's the minor or the small type of idgham and not the big idgham. And the example of that is, وَشْتَعَلَ رَاشَيْبَ. Okay? أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الشيخ إمام تفضل